If you're wanting to do real estate research in St. Charles County, the GIS mapping tool is a fantastic place to gather information. Whether you work for a title company, a real estate agent, a land developer, or are simply a St. Charles County resident curious about their community, so much information can be gathered in this one convenient tool. This video will teach you the best way of getting the information you're looking for and how to make the most out of the GIS mapping service. While the on-screen icons have a vast amount of information tucked behind them, you may find it easiest to click on the parcel of your choice. This will show the account number, site address, mailing address, property type, municipality, fire district, and estimated parcel acreage. This is also an opportunity to take a look at the site's assessed value and any additional parcel details that have been curated by St. Charles County. If you're looking for more in-depth information, the best place to start is to familiarize yourself with the user interface. Along the top, you'll see a gray bar with six icons and a search bar. The leftmost icon is the Legends tab. This gives you a breakdown of what each symbol, color, and line represent in the map information. These clarify water features, road jurisdictions, as well as where each municipality begins and ends. By default, you'll see parcel information when you click on a portion of the map. To delve into more information, look at the Layers tab. Under this icon, you'll find ways to toggle map information regarding transportation, tax information, voting districts, utilities, planning and zoning districts, physical features, and topography information. If the toggle you select doesn't immediately show up on the map, there are a few things to try. First, make sure that the parent toggle of the layer you want to see is also selected. Your zoom level on the map may also affect your selection. If the item you have selected is grayed out, it means the information isn't available at the current zoom level. To the right is the Bookmark tab. This icon allows you to quickly zoom the map into municipalities around the county. If you find you're frequently looking at specific spots throughout the county, you can create labeled markers to quickly return to those spots. Next to the Bookmark tab, you'll find the Base Map Gallery. This includes options for satellite imagery that date back to 2012, as well as a color-coordinated version of the map showing municipalities. You'll find the Query tab next to that. Here you can search by account number, municipality, fire district, school district, property type, or neighborhood to narrow the results. Once you've picked your criteria, you'll find a filtered list of information. If you're unfamiliar with GIS maps, you'll find the Help tab particularly useful. Once you click on it, you'll find a detailed breakdown and quick reference materials for each of the site's features, including short moving images of some of the primary features, their purpose, and how to use them, and the search bar. Here you can search by address or parcel number. Press enter and the map will jump to your specified location. Then click on the parcel to see a detailed list of information. Now let's look at the tools along the left-hand side of the screen. First, the Pictometry tab. With this tool, you'll be able to see a bird's eye view of the area of your choice. You can use the compass arrows in the upper left to see the different angles of a given parcel. Using the arrows along the top allows you to cycle between land images from previous years. To see more or less detail, click on the Layers icon to add or remove street names and place names, contours, and parcel information. The Advanced Identify tab allows you to sort by parcel and create a radius around that given spot to see information regarding the surrounding parcels. There are also rudimentary drawing tools to add visual guidelines for printing or exporting a PDF of the on-screen information. You can also obtain longitudinal and latitudinal information on a given spot on the map. The Draw tab features similar tools to the Advanced Identify tab, but there are more options to add visual information to the map data. Here, you can choose to add things such as arrows, markers, shapes, and text information for use when exporting an image of the mapping data. When using any of the tools, double-clicking will finalize any graphics you add. The Measurement tool is the best place for obtaining information regarding acreage and measurement information. The Polygonal tool will show you the acreage of the shape you draw over the map. While the Line tool will allow you to place points along the map and see the distance covered along the path that you created. Depending on your needs, there is a drop-down menu on the right that allows you to change the units of measurement. The Print tool is where you can save and export information you've gathered from the site, including any drawn-on information you have added. Name your file and click Print. Click on the PDF the website generates to open it in the PDF reader of your choice. You can then send this PDF to your printer to create a printout of your data. The final elements of the user interface are along the bottom of the screen. Much like Google Maps, there are plus and minus buttons that represent zooming in and out, respectively. The home icon will zoom you all the way out to show you the boundaries of the GIS mapping data. The circular icon will use your current location as a reference point to give you information. This is particularly useful if you're wanting information on your current location. Finally, at the bottom edge of the display is an arrow icon. Clicking on this while in the area of your choice will create cells of information about the given area that can be easily exported into Microsoft Excel, Google Sheets, or Apple Numbers. To learn more about GIS mapping services, visit sccmo.org/GIS services.